everybody, this is your girl Melody Trice, and you are watching The Melody Trice Show. We're live here on the green carpet for Dance with Femmes. So you want to stay tuned to all the amazing interviews that's going to happen right here. We'll be right back. Those actors and for this film, what were some of the things that you guys was looking for?
To be honest, we had worked with everybody that we cast before. Actually, all of the names of the actors is the names of the characters because I wrote it with them in mind. Not because they are that way, but because I wanted to write it in their voice. Because I thought they were just incredibly talented. And for this film, I mean, that's really what we were looking for. I think if anyone sees the film, it's just like the acting carries completely all of the emotions that the lead is going through and everybody else. And so that was our biggest thing that we were really looking to do.
I'm quite well, thank you.
So, you know, being here today, what do that mean to you to just be a part of something so great?
It's so special because we did it with a group of friends. This is peers working together, and instead of trying to climb up the system and pounding down the door of Hollywood, we worked together.
So it means an awful lot to be here and being able to represent them and their production company by playing this role in their film.
So what do you think people want to think?
It's amazing. It's amazing. It's such a beautiful film. It's such an amazing project, and we're all such a great group of friends, so it's also very exciting to be together here. And Selena, who wrote it and produced it, is so talented. And
she wrote it like with us in mind. Actually, our names in the film are our actual names in real life, which is like kind of funny. Yeah, so yeah, she wrote it with us in mind, and it was just an honor.
As an actor, as an artist, it's all you could ask for to be a part of something that you're proud to show, you know, and you just show up to set and you give what you have, you take the script. And
oh my God, just really tell us what inspired you to write this film.
Well, when we first got engaged, actually, I was super young for LA. I was 24 years old. And so I had a lot of friends who had some very strange reactions to me getting married. And instead of being really happy, some people were not so happy. And so I kind of wanted to tell a story through that point of view. But also kind of talk a little bit about what it means to get married and to grow up and whether one thing has to do with the other or not. Or, you know, I think there's so many ways that you can live your life these days, and there's a lot of pressure on social media as to what you're supposed to do by what point. So a lot of the film is really about self-acceptance and learning that, you know, there is no one way. It's just being okay with yourself.
Well, I've got the film here in the festival. It's called Brock Bledsoe, Future Hero. It's a short film. It's a comedy spoof on making movies in Hollywood, basically, and difficulties dealing with people on sets, et cetera, et cetera. I've got another television project coming up, which I'm pretty excited about. I can't say too much about it because the ink isn't dry yet, but we're really close.
I mean, I think just looking back on it from day one, we just wanted to say it's okay to talk about this kind of thing, that if you're in a bad place or you need some help, it's okay to reach out, not using the title of the film, pun intended, but you know. Yeah, we just wanted to create a dialogue about it, and it's been an awesome experience, and to hear people say it's really touched them or in a positive way is even better. That's all I could ask for, frankly.
Hi, my name is Salman Sayed, and I'm the editor on the documentary Purdah.
So tell us a little bit about this film.
So Purdah is a documentary following Kekija Mirza, who is a 20-year-old girl in Mumbai, India. And she believes herself to be the only Muslim girl training to make the Indian women's senior cricket team in Mumbai. And the story really follows her. She comes from a community where all the women wear burqas. And in order to play cricket, she gets permission from her father to remove the burqa so she can go try out for the cricket team. So the documentary follows her trying out for the team. And the film's called Purdah, which means veil, and because it's a documentary, it follows real life.
Well, I've seen a lot of great stuff this week, you know, a lot of great films and stories, and all in different styles. What I love is that there's room for all of those styles. You know, it's not like we're all having to compete for something, that there's room for all of this great content to be made. And I love that. I think as filmmakers, we get so stuck into our, like, this is so hard for me. My movie was so hard to make, and there were so many things, challenges to overcome. But when you hear that story over and over again from every filmmaker here, it's great knowing that we're a part of this community that's doing it together.
Hello, everybody. This is your girl, Melody Trice. It has been so amazing being here at the Chinese Theater for Dancing with the Films. Being on the green carpet, I think that's so amazing. And one thing that I would say has stood out so much is just seeing how these creative minds have came together and guess what, have produced something that is so great. Everybody has a story, and I know you have a story to tell as well. Keep living life unlimited. Make sure that you continue to follow the Melody Trice Show. And now we're on Roku. So go to your Roku channel and make sure that you put in that search bar, Melody Trice Television. Till next time, I'm your girl, Melody Trice. Bye-bye. This is your